Hi, I'm Keith Krieger, Program Director for Computer Applications Training at JCCC. And today we have some tools, tips, and techniques to help you do your work with common computer applications every day. PowerPoint's a presentation tool, and there's some tools that are built into PowerPoint that can help us control the delivery and the smoothness of a presentation. And a couple things that we need to know about PowerPoint to make this happen. We do have slide numbers in PowerPoint, and by default, if you use an included PowerPoint template, it includes an item in the footer called slide number. And speakers will often put the slide number on their slides by default, and quite frankly, the audience doesn't care what slide number you are on. But as a speaker, you do indeed care about what slide number you are on. And we can use that slide number tool as a way to move around within the presentation. So if I look at the presentation I have here, it's a 10-slide presentation, and I may want to move very quickly between slides. And we've all seen presenters do this. I'm going to start up the presentation here. I'm going to use the keyboard here instead of clicking the mouse. F5 on the keyboard will automatically start the presentation for me. I'm going to move through the first couple of slides. I'm just going to tap the space bar. Easy way to move through. And let's assume that during our presentation, someone asks about some kind of content back on slide number 2. And we've all seen speakers do this. They'll either go back through the slides, they'll flip through them, they'll scroll, they'll do right clicks and go to slide and do that, and you can see how clunky that is. It really slows down the presentation. If I know a slide number, I can tell PowerPoint exactly which slide to go to. So I'm sitting here on a slide and I get a question from the audience who says, can you go back and talk about the content that you touched on earlier? And you can say, sure, let me go back to that slide. If I know the slide number, all I have to do is type that number on the keyboard and press enter, and I automatically go back to that slide. Now, at this point, some people are probably thinking, well, okay, this is cool, but how do I know the slide numbers? Let me show you how you get your slide numbers. I'm going to press escape here. That will get me out of the show and get me back to PowerPoint. PowerPoint, since very, very early days, has had an outline view. And you can see over here on the left, it's docked with my thumbnails. This is PowerPoint 2010. And when I click the outline tab, it shows me the contents of each slide in outline format. And you'll notice that each slide has a number. So there's my slide numbers. So there's slide number 2, where I zoomed back to. So I need to know, when I'm presenting, what slide number I need to go to. Now the other way that you get to that information is you tell PowerPoint, print the outline. I'm going to go to the file menu and choose print. And what I want to do with printing is I want to do indeed print all slides, but the thing that I want to print is my outline. And we have a preview here, and this is exactly what your print version would look like. If I have that print version close at hand during the presentation and someone asks me to return to a specific slide, I glance at the presentation, type that number, and I'm taken directly to that slide. If you want to look very, very smooth with this, before you leave the slide to go to that slide that the person in the audience asked about, make a mental note of the slide that you left, and as soon as you're finished with that discussion, you type the slide number of the slide you left and you're returned exactly where you left off. Makes the whole presentation much more smooth, much more effective, and we see less of those kinds of fumbling around on the slides for the audience. Now there's some other simple tools during a presentation that will help you, and again I'm going to press F5 to start the show. There's a number of different ways to move from slide to slide. I can tap the space bar, I can press enter, I can press up arrow, I can press right arrow. All of those things will move me forward in the presentation. If I want to move backwards in the presentation, Rather than do right clicks, I can just do backspace. And I'm moving backwards in the presentation. There are times when we don't want necessarily the audience to see what's on the screen. That is, we want to take the focus away from what is on the screen so the focus comes to us as the presenter. And a very quick and easy way to do that is to get a black screen. We touch the B key on the keyboard and we get a black screen. Touch B again and presentation comes back. Now, there's a number of keyboard shortcuts like this we can use during a presentation. And the easy way to find them when you're rehearsing is we need to use the universal keyboard for help. We need to use F1 on the keyboard. And when you are in a presentation, rehearsing, you don't want to show this during the show, here's a list of all the keyboard shortcuts. So the very top one there, N to move forward, backspace to move backwards, the number followed by Enter. There's your shortcut on how to move between slides in a presentation. B for a black screen, W for a white screen. So a number of different tools here that easy to memorize, easy to recall, and really adds a very smooth professional touch to your presentations. And a quick 4 or 5 minutes of memorization of those tools will really pay off when you're in front of an audience. We trust you found the tips and tools, techniques in these videos to be helpful in something you can put to use almost immediately. We know that these are things that can be shared easily, and we encourage you to share them with your colleagues and your friends. Post them to Facebook or Twitter or LinkedIn for other people to take advantage of. And if you like, we'd be happy to send you the notes of the tools and techniques that we've shown you here today. Please feel free to send us a message at the address on the screen, and we'll get those right out to you. Thanks.